गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज विनीत श्रीवास्तव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन. दिस इज द सेकंड वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ EC503, दैट इज CNTL, कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क एंड ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. सो इन दिस सेकंड वीडियो लेक्चर वी डिस्कस हियर अटेन्यूएटर्स एंड वी कवर द अटेन्यूएटर in three video lectures. In the previous video lecture, we discussed about the introduction of the communication network and the transmission lines, in which we discuss what is the communication network and what is the use of the transmission lines, and some industrial applications, real life examples. So if we are talking about some real life examples, so attenuator are basically important topic. So here in this video lecture we discuss what is the attenuators, some real life examples of the attenuators, designing of attenuators, and solve some numerical problems. So we move to the forward. Here we discuss about the outlines. First prerequisite, definitely we have a requirement of prerequisite before any topic. We have some objective. What is the objective? Introduction of attenuator. We start technical content by the introduction of the attenuator. Then we move to the types of attenuator, that is symmetrical or asymmetrical. So we discuss about the symmetrical and asymmetrical attenuators, how we can identify whether the attenuator is symmetrical or asymmetrical. Basic attenuator terminologies, some important terminologies basically used in the designing process of the attenuators, that is attenuations. We have some notations, and these notations are used in the derivation, also used in the numerical process. Then we discuss here symmetrical T attenuator with derivation, derive the designing equations, because finally we want to design the attenuators. So there's a requirement of the designing equations. So here in symmetrical T attenuator, we design two designing equations. With the help of this, we can easily design and solve the numerical problems. After derivation and after we find out the expression of the designing equation, we move to the numerical problems related to the symmetrical T attenuators. Then we have an exercise based on previous discussions. Definitely, we have learning outcomes. After completion of video lecture, at the end, we have covered some outcomes. So the learning outcome is also important considerable factor. In the last, we have references. So these are the overall outlines of this video lecture. Now we move to the forward and discuss about the prerequisites. The students should have a basic knowledge of KVL and KCL, that is Kirchhoff voltage law and Kirchhoff current law. All of the students are basically cover the KVL and KCL in network analysis. So all the students having a lot of idea of the Kirchhoff voltage law and Kirchhoff current law, because when we derive the designing equations for any network, there is a requirement of the KVL and KCL for solving a circuit. Use KVL and KCL, also used in numericals. So student having some knowledge of KVL and KCL. Now the second prerequisites, student should have a basic knowledge of voltage and current division, because we use voltage and current division formula and logic are used in the derivation along with numericals problem. So student having some knowledge related with voltage and current division. This is also covered in network analysis. I think a lot of the students are basically having a good idea of KVL, KCL and voltage and current distribution. Students should have a basic knowledge of log and anti-logs, because we are taking some logarithmic expression and the values also along with anti-log. So we have students should have a basic knowledge of log and anti-log. So these are the prerequisite. All the students are basically having a very good knowledge about this. Now we have objectives. Students are able to understand the basic concept of attenuators, because when we discuss the attenuators, so the basic target is that students are easily understand the basic concept of attenuators, so that they can design attenuators easily. Because if the concept are not clear, so the designing are not easy. But if we easily understand the basic concept, then we can easily design the attenuator. So the basic concept is very important. Then we go for identification of symmetrical and asymmetrical attenuators. How we can identify whether the network is symmetrical or asymmetrical? So this is another objective. There is some logic in the concept. With the help of this, we can easily find out the symmetrical and asymmetrical attenuators, because in the designing we cover symmetrical and as well as asymmetrical both attenuators. So for before designing, the identification is very important, whether the attenuator is symmetrical or whether the attenuator is asymmetrical. Finally, our target is the designing of symmetrical attenuator. So we complete the designing of symmetrical T attenuator. Especially in this video lecture, we cover only symmetrical T attenuators. In the upcoming video lectures, we are covering the other symmetrical or as well as asymmetrical attenuator. So finally, our target is basically the designing of the attenuators. So first we understand the concept, then we identify whether the attenuator is symmetrical or asymmetrical, and then we go for the designing process. So these are the overall objective of this particular video lecture. Now we discuss about the attenuators. What is the concept of the attenuators? So we are talking about attenuators here. So attenuators are used to reduce the signal level by a given amount. Okay, we have amplifier which increase the voltage level. What is the working of the amplifier? They amplify the voltage level. And attenuator are just work opposite of amplifier. Attenuator means attenuation. The word coming from attenuation. Attenuation means loss. Reduce the voltage level. So attenuator is just opposite of amplifier. Attenuator are used to reduce the signal level by a given amount. Signal in term of voltage or magnitude. So they reduce the voltage level. Attenuator are usually resistive device. It means attenuator are basically a totally resistive device. So if we are talking about the real example, so the mobile charger is a good example of attenuator. All the adapters are a good example of attenuators. Why? Because the mobile charger are basically convert the 220 volt up to 8 to 10 volts, because the mobile charging requirement is 8 to 10 volt. So the mobile charger convert 220 volt down into up to 10 volt. So they attenuate the voltage level. So all the adapter, whether we are required any adapter in laboratory, in labs, these are work as a attenuator. So in real life, attenuator have a great importance. Okay. So there are two type of attenuator, as we discussed, symmetrical and asymmetrical. How we can identify that the attenuator is symmetrical or asymmetrical? Because attenuator having a two port, one is the input port, another is the output port. So if there is a perfect matching, it means input impedance or input resistance equal to output resistance. If Rn equal to Rout, if there is a perfect matching between input and output, the attenuator is symmetrical. If Rn is not equal to Rout, input impedance or resistance is not equal to output impedance or resistance, then the attenuator is asymmetrical. So the condition of the symmetrical is Rn equal to Rout. Condition for asymmetrical, Rn is not equal to Rout. So we can easily find out whether the attenuator is symmetrical or asymmetrical. Now we move to some note points. These are basic important terminologies which are used in the designing of attenuators or the designing of numericals here. Attenuator is only a resistive device. It will introduce no phase shift, because due to resistance, there is a no phase shift. Phase shift is introduced due to the inductor or capacitance. So we know that the propagation constant P equal to alpha plus j beta here, where the alpha is attenuation constant and beta is phase constant, because whenever a signal or wave are propagated, there is always attenuation along with phase. But in case of attenuator, there is only a resistive device. That's why the possibility of the phase is zero. There is a no phase change because it is a resistive device. Due to resistance, there is a no phase shift or change. So the beta is zero. If the beta is zero, in case of attenuator, beta is zero. And when we put the value of beta is zero in equation one here, so this beta is zero, P equal to alpha here. It means propagation constant equal to attenuation constant. So in case of attenuator, P equal to alpha, beta is zero. So no phase shift, only attenuation. There is a P equal to alpha, there is no beta. So there is a phase, no phase shift, only attenuation. That's why it is known as attenuator. Okay. Now we move to the forward and discuss note point number two. In the attenuation is usually given in dB or Napper. So the relation between dB and Napper is 1 Napper equal to 8.868 dB. 1 Napper equal to 8.868 dB. So this relation are used during the numerical. If the answer in the form of dB or if the answer in the form of Napper, we can easily convert from Napper to dB or dB to Napper. So we use this relation. 1 Napper equal to 8.868 dB. Okay. Now on note point number 3. The attenuation is given by, this is important formula, student concentrating here. So the attenuation is represented by capital D equal to 10 log 10 to the base P1 upon P2. It is in the form of dB, where P1 is input power and P2 is output power. So attenuation formula, D equal to 10 log 10 to the base P1 upon P2. P1 is input power, P2 is output power. We use this formula in numericals. For convenience, we just denote n equal to under root p1 p2 here, just for convenience. So we are taking square both sides, so we have p1 upon p2 equal to n square. So we replace this p1 p2 in equation 2, we replace this p1 p2 in equation 2 by n square. So the equation 2 becomes here, we put the value of p1 upon p2 equal to n square in equation 2. So we have 10 log 10 to the base n square, because p1 and p2 is replaced by n square. So d equal to 10 log 10 to the base n square. This 2 is coming forward, multiply with 10. So this is 20 log 10 to the base n. Student concentrating here, these are important formulas. D equal to 20 log 10 to the base n. If we want to calculate, suppose that in numerical we have d, we have attenuation are given, so we can easily calculate n, because the designing equation is depend on n. So the n is nt log d by 20. This is d by 20. 20 is divided by here, d by 20, nt log d by 20. So if we have d, we can easily calculate n by this formula. We put the value of d here, taking nt log, so we have n. So these formula are very important in point of view of numerical problems. So here we calculate easily D and N, and we have one relation, that is 1 Napper equal to 8.868 dB. Now we move to forward. That is a note point number 4. This is important note point again. For symmetrical attenuator, both the pair of terminals are matched to the same resistance, that is characteristic resistance. I am already discussed. For symmetrical attenuator, both the resistance means input resistance, input impedance equal to output impedance or output resistance. And the value of both is equivalent to characteristic resistance. Rn equal to Rout equal to R0. So we know that when input impedance resistance equal to output impedance resistance, then the attenuator is symmetrical. So we use this concept, and the value of Rn equal to Rout equal to R0. That is characteristic resistance here. Okay. So we know that P1 upon P2, formula of the power is I square R. So P1 is the input power. So I square means current of the input side, that is source side. So this is represented by I square S. R is the input resistance. P2 is the output power. So the output power means resistance is R out and current is at the receiver. Output means receiver side. S means source side, input side. So that is I square R, output current, output resistance R out, represented by equation number 3. As we know that for symmetrical attenuator, input resistance equal to output resistance and having the value is equivalent to R naught. If the value is not equivalent to R naught, then it is already cancelled to each other. So with the help of this, in case of symmetrical network, Rn equal to R out. So when Rn equal to R out, so these are cancelled to each other. Here in equation 3, put in equation 3, this value Rn equal to R out equal to put in equation 3. So the equation 3 is now converted in this form. P1 upon P2 equal to I square S, source current, input current upon I square R, output current, R0 upon R0, Rn and R out are replaced by R0, cancelled to each other. So we have P1 upon P2 equal to Is upon Ir whole square. This is represented by equation number 4. P1 upon P2 equal to Is upon Ir whole square. Note point number 5. As we know that for convenience, we already denote N equal to under root P1 upon P2. So N square equal to P1 upon P2 from equation 4. We already know that. We used the notation earlier. So here, P1 upon P2 equal to N square. So in equation 4, this is P1 upon P2 is replaced by N square. Okay. So this is N square equal to Is upon Ir whole square. N square equal to Is upon Ir whole square. Now, we move to the forward. Here we derive the designing equations for symmetrical T attenuators. So this is the structure of symmetrical T attenuator, because this is the T type structure here. One resistance here, one here. So this is just T, and Rn and R out are equal because the network symmetrical T attenuator. Attenuator is symmetrical. In case of symmetrical, Rn equal to R out and both values are equal to R naught. So Rn is R naught, R out is also R naught. So Rn equal to R naught, Rn equal to R out, both the resistance, input and output terminal are same. That's why attenuator is symmetrical. Okay. So first, according to current division rule here, this current I1 is flow. So from this node, I2 is here and some other current is here like I1 minus I2. But we are concentrating over the I2. So this is the current I2 is flow here. So according to the current division rule, I2 equal to total current is I1. Total current is I1 and the opposite resistance is R2. Current flow is I2 here, so opposite resistance is R2. So this is R2 upon total resistance. This is R1 by 2, R2 and R0. So the sum is R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2. Student, again concentrating here, according to the current division rule, I2 equal to total current I1. This is total current I1. Opposite resistance is R2. R2 and total resistance is R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2. R1 by 2, R2 and R0. So this is the current division. So this is the equation number 1. We know that N equal to I1 upon I2. We previously discussed in previous slides. N equal to I1 upon I2. Equation number 2. So from equation one, if the equation one is arranged in form of I1 upon I2, so from equation one, we have this equation, okay? So this is I1 upon I2 equal to, so this factor is in numerator and this is denominator. So I1 upon I2 from equation one, we have R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2 upon R2. So this is I1 upon I2. And we know that I1 upon I2 is N from equation two. So this I1 upon I2 is replaced by N. So we have N equal to R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2 upon R2. So this equation is converted into this form. Okay. So we have equation 3 here. Now we move to the forward for properly terminated network because the attenuator is symmetrical. So we know the condition Rn equal to Rout, that is equivalent to R0, perfect matching. Again, the structure of symmetrical T attenuator. So here we first calculate the total input resistance. So we are looking from this side. This Rn is equivalent to R0. This R0 is also represent Rn. And this R0 is also represent Rout. So first we want to calculate Rn, total equivalent resistance of the circuit. And this Rn is equivalent to R0. So R1 by 2 and R0 in series. Okay. So in series, both the resistance are added. R1 by 2 plus R0 in series. And combination of this series is parallel with R2. So R1 by 2 plus R0 parallel with R2. That's why we use R1 by 2 plus R0 and R2 are in parallel. So R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So one resistance is R1 by 2 plus R0 into R2 upon R1 by 2 plus R2 plus R0. So what is this combination? Both are in series, added and parallel with R2. This is the overall resistance. And then this is added with in series with R1 by 2. So this is series in R1 by 2. That's why plus R1 by 2. So the overall resistance is Rn equal to R1 by 2 plus R2 into R1 by 2 plus R0 upon R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2, equation number 4. We have N equal to R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2 upon, we have N equal to R0 plus R1 by 2, okay, plus R2 upon total divided by R2. We already previously discussed this on previous slide. So this, if we are concentrating here, this value, if we are concentrating here, this. Here we have R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2 and total divided by R2. But this is just opposite R2 upon. So if this is N, so this value is 1 upon N. So the 1 upon N means R2 upon R0 plus R1 by 2 plus R2. So this value is replaced by here 1 upon N. So this equation is converted this. R1 by 2 plus as it is plus, and this is replaced by 1 upon N, and this is as it is replaced here. So the equation is convert in this form. Okay. Now we move to the forward. For the designing of symmetrical attenuator, what is the requirement? We want to value of R1 by 2 and we want to value of R2. So we find out the designing equations for R1 by 2 and R2. This is the target. Now in term of R0 or N. Now we cross multiply to each other the previous equation, then separate R0 from one side, taking R0 common. So we have N minus 1. So in the structure, we have one resistance is R1 by 2. So the R1 by 2 equal to R0 into N minus 1 upon N plus 1. So this is the one designing equation, because in the structure of symmetrical T attenuator, we have a one resistance which having the value of R1 by 2. So this is the first designing equation. This is, student, remember this as a formula, because this is the designing equation used in numerical problems. Now from equation 3, we have already have N equal to this value, cross multiply each other, separate R2 term from one side, taking R2 is common. So we have R2 equal to N minus R2 into N minus 1 equal to R0 plus R1 by 2. Because our second target, we want to find out the value of R2. So here R2 equal to this R0 plus R1 by 2. And we find out the value in term of R0 or N. So from here, this R1 by 2 is replaced because you already calculate R1 by 2. So we put the value of R1 by 2, that is R0 N minus 1 upon N plus 1. So So we put the value of R1 by 2 from here. This. Put value R1 by 2 from equation number 5. So when we put the value, this is value is put here. And when we solve, so we have the another designing equation, that is R2 equal to R0 2n upon n square minus 1. So if we have characteristic resistance is given, and if we have attenuation, with the help of attenuation we calculate n. So if we have R0 or n, we can easily calculate the value of R1 by 2 and R2, because these are the two resistance which are used in the designing of symmetrical T attenuator. Okay, so these are equation 5 and 6 used as a designing equations. Now we move to the numerical problems. That is, design symmetrical T attenuator with attenuation of 20 dB and designing impedance of 600 ohm. So what is the given? Attenuation D equal to 20 dB given. Designing impedance, that is a characteristic resistance or impedance, that is R0. So 20 dB and 600 ohm, D and R0 is given. We know that the formula of symmetrical T attenuator, we already derived R1 by 2 equal to R0 n minus 1 upon n plus 1. So the formula based on R0 and n. So here R0 is given, but n is not given. But with the help of the formula n equal to nt log 10 to the base d by 20, we can easily calculate n. We already discussed this formula. So here we put d equal to 20, nt log of 1, n equal to 10. So we have n equal to 10, and we have R0 equal to 600. We use the designing equation formula R0 n minus 1, R0 is 600, n is 10. When we solve this, R1 by 2 equal to 490.9 ohm. So this is the one resistance which are used in the designing of symmetrical T attenuator. Now we move to the next, that is R2 equal to R0 2n upon n square minus 1. This is the second designing equation. So we put R0 equal to 600, n equal to 10. When we solve, R2 equal to 121.21 ohm. Then we know about the structure of symmetrical T network, that is R0. That is R0. Here we place R1 by 2, here we place R1 by 2, and here we have R2. Student, if you mentioned here something voltage source, it may be possible or not. So we have R0 equal to 600 ohm given. R1 by 2 calculate 490.9. R2 equal to 121.21. So we place all the values. Then this is the final designing. If you can simply calculate, and there is a no circuit are mentioned here, so this is not complete designing. For the complete designing, we first calculate the value and then place this value in the circuit or exact structure. So this is the overall symmetrical T attenuators and the final designing of T attenuators. So this can be done with the help of designing equations. Now we move to the exercise. Explain in brief unit of attenuation, obtain relation between the two units. So we also discuss about the attenuations and the units of two units. We also derive the relations between dB and Napers. So you can easily do this. Explain step by step designing methods for attenuators. So here we derive the formula and also solve one numerical problem. So with the help of this, we can easily explain the step-by-step designing method for attenuator. Next one, what is resistive attenuator? So we also discussed about the basics of attenuator. What is an attenuator? Classify attenuators. We also discussed attenuator and its classification. So here, the exercise question are based on totally discussion. Now we have moved to the learning outcomes. What is the learning outcomes? Students are in such a position to understand the basic concept of attenuators. We all discussed all the basic concept. Identification of symmetrical asymmetrical attenuators. We also discussed the logic concept, how we can identify the symmetrical and asymmetrical attenuators. Design symmetrical T attenuator with the help of designing equation. We derive the equations already, and then we solve one numerical problem based on designing equation, so we can easily design symmetrical T attenuators. So in the upcoming video lecture, we discuss about some other different attenuators like pi attenuators, lattice attenuators, bridge attenuators. Here we derived the designing equation, also solved some numerical problems. Then we discussed about some asymmetrical networks in the asymmetrical attenuators in the upcoming video lectures. So overall concept of the attenuator is reduce the voltage level opposite of the amplifier, and some of the applications attenuator are widely used. These are the references: Umesh Sinha, Rajesh Dubey, Communication Network Publications, Satya Publications, UK Bakshi, AB Bakshi, Communication Network Transmission Line Technical Publications. So you can use these publications as a reference. Thank you, students.